ओके सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई थिंक वी हैव कवर्ड सम ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फ्लूइड. सो वील रिवाइज सम प्रॉपर्टीज बिकॉज दीज आर बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज एंड वेरी मच इम्पोर्टेंट टू लर्न द फ्यूचर कंसेप्ट ऑफ फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स. So who will tell what we have learned in the last lecture? Anybody of you? Anybody of you who will? Anybody of you who will tell last lecture what we have completed? Some of the properties we have completed? Anybody? Okay, so
हेलो सर, फ्लूइड
हाँ, यू कैन
कॉन्सेप्ट सर।
फ्लूड कंसेप्ट. सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय फ्लूड मैके ओके पर टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूड्स वर कवर्ड. सो हु विल टेल व्हिच आर द डिफरेंट इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूड्स. टेल टेल
क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फ्लूइड सर।
ओके. सो व्हाट आर द न्यूटन व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड मीन्स व्हाट. एनीबडी दीज आर बेसिक्स. हाँ ओके
द फ्लूइड विच ओबेस न्यूटन्स विस्कोसिटी लॉ।
ओके द फ्लूड विच ओबेस न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ विस्कोसिटी आर कॉल्ड एज न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वाटर ओके पेट्रोल डीजल दीज आर कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड्स. एंड फॉर देम शियर स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू शियर स्ट्रेन. ओके देन वी हैव कम अक्रॉस दिस डेंसिटी ऑफ द फ्लूड. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी डेंसिटी ऑफ द फ्लूड. हाउ वी डिफाइन डेंसिटी ऑफ द फ्लूड. एनी फ्लूड और डेंसिटी हाउ वी डिफाइन. तो डेंसिटी इज नथिंग बट मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. ओके एंड एट स्टैंडर्ड कंडीशन एसटीपी कंडीशन दैट इज एट एटमोस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर टू 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड एट 1 एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर डेंसिटी इज डिफाइंड एज मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर वेयर कंसिडरिंग एज ए 1000 kg पर मीटर क्यूब. एंड मर्क्यूरी इज देयर वी आर कंसिडरिंग इट एज ए 13,600 kg पर मीटर क्यूब. ओके सो डेंसिटी ऑफ एनी गैस इज देयर इट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू बी कंसिडर्ड एज मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. सो एयर डेंसिटी वी आर कंसिडरिंग इट एज ए 1.0205 और रफली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट इट विल बिकम 1 kg पर मीटर क्यूब. देन स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम इज अनदर प्रॉपर्टी. एनीबडी ऑफ यू हाउ यू डिफाइन स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम. प्लीज डिफाइन स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम. हाउ यू डिफाइन स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम.
वॉल्यूम पर यूनिट मास।
वॉल्यूम पर यूनिट मास और ऑल्सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज reciprocal of the density. Okay, so specific volume generally it is used for the compressible fluids. So we have defined again density mass per unit volume. Standard density of water is 1000 or 998 exactly value. Then density of water 1.2 kg per meter cube or roughly we say consider it as a 1 kg per meter cube. Then mass density some of the numericals are there here. So we can calculate the mass density of by using the equation only. Density is equal to mass upon volume. So if wood is there one in this on the in the screen, So wood having mass 2 kg and volume occupied by that wood of mass 2 kg is 4000 centimeter cube. Then its density will be 2 kg divided by 4000 into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay. So it will become value will be here wood density will be 500 kg per meter cube. And at the same time they have given that here lead, one of the lead box is there, is having mass 45.2 kg and occupying the same volume 4000 centimeter cube, then its density will be 11000. It give you, do the calculation, mass is 45.2 and divided by volume is 4000 centimeter cube, that we have to convert into meter cube. Okay, so it will be 4000 into 10 raised to minus 6, and in that case if you do the calculation, the mass density will be 11000 here 300 kg per meter cube. Okay. Then we are having for the same mass will be 2 kg, but volume will be required of lead will be very less, 177 centimeter cube. Again the same density will come, that is 11300 kg per meter cube. Or for that, considering that density and considering mass as a 2 kg, so yellowish here 2 kg here, we can calculate the volume is equal to 177 centimeter cube. So this is very simple formula we have to remember. An example is there here, the density of steel is 7800 kg per meter cube. What is the volume of 4 kg of steel? So density is equal to mass upon volume, therefore volume is equal to m upon rho. So mass is 4 kg divided by its density, and volume will become 5.13 into 10 raised to minus 4, or it is converted into centimeter cube, then here 513 centimeter cube. So what is the volume mass, if the what is the mass for the same steel here, for the same steel here, what is the mass if the volume is 0.046 meter cube? Then again same formula we have to use, rho is equal to mass upon volume, volume is equal, therefore mass is equal to rho into volume, and rho is knowing 7800 kg per meter cube into volume is 0.046 meter cube, and in that case mass is coming as 359 kg. Then very another important property related to here it with relation with mass density, that property is called as specific weight, or it is called as weight per unit volume. Okay, and this property we are calculating by how it is weight per unit volume, but weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity, and therefore here this specific weight denoted by small w, or denoted by small w, and is coming as what here, rho into g. So relation is there, here it is there, here I have highlighted it. So specific weight small w is equal to rho into g. They have given gamma, but here we are considering as a small w, and the unit is equal to newton per meter cube. So generally water specific gravity, specific weight of water, they are asking it will be rho into g. So specific density of water is equal to 998 into 10 into g, 9.81. so it is coming as nearly 9790 newton per meter cube. Or if you consider 1000 roughly density, 1000 into 9.81, it is equal to 9810. So 9810 also is going to be valid answer. So specific weight of air will be 1 into 9.81, so 9.81 newton per meter cube. Or if you consider it as accurately, 1.20 into 9.81, so it is coming as 11.8 newton per meter cube. Then another property, anybody of you can guess, it is we have considered as a specific gravity. So how we define specific gravity, anybody of you? Specific gravity, how we define specific gravity? Specific gravity is
the ratio of density of liquid to density of water.
Density of liquid to density of water, very good. And or it is specific weight of liquid divided by specific weight of water. Okay, So water is considered as here standard fluid or reference fluid. So with reference to that water, we can calculate the specific gravity. Who will tell now? Or in message box you can write. So everybody can will get chance. What is the unit of specific gravity? What is the unit of specific gravity? Samadhan. What is the unit of specific gravity? Anybody of you? No unit. Okay. Nikita Paul answered no unit. Okay. So no unit is there. For here only. SG specific gravity is dimensionless and independent of system of units. So water specific gravity is 1. Mercury specific gravity is 13.55. Or if you consider density as a 13,600, it will become 13.6. So in many books they have given 13.6 as a specific gravity of mercury, and density will become in that case 13,600 kg per meter cube. Then specific gravity, the specific gravity or relative density, another name for specific gravity is relative density, because it is calculated in terms with respect to the water as a relative fluid density, relative fluid. The specific gravity of relative density can be defined in two ways. Definition one, ratio of density of a liquid to the density of water. Okay, remember that only. Ratio of density of liquid to the density of water at standard temperature and pressure, STP condition. Then, or ratio of specific weight of liquid to the specific weight of water. So, but we know that rho into g, g, g will get cancelled. So, both relations are valid. The specific gravity is defined as rho of liquid divided by rho of water, 1000 generally we are considering, or rho of here specific weight of liquid divided by specific weight of water. So this property also we have completed. The specific gravity or relative density of a material is the ratio of its density to the density of water. So rho of x. So steel, if you want, we want to calculate the relative density of specific gravity of steel with respect to water, then having density 7800 kg per meter cube, then the relative density of steel will become 7.80. Brass, it will become 8700. Okay, but it is with respect to water only. Okay. So with this, we have completed up to this, I think. Then viscosity in a fluid, that also we have defined. Anybody of you can define or revise viscosity? What is meant by viscosity? Anybody of you?
Viscosity is defined as the internal flow resistance to flow.
Okay, it is defined as internal resistance for its own flow. So nothing, it is having only viscosity means what? Internal resistance for its own flow. So there is a resistance created by the molecular specification or molecular orders in case of the fluids, and that is called as viscosity. So due to that, there is a resistance or disturbance for the flow. Okay, so viscosity is, there are two types of viscosities. One is dynamic viscosity and another is kinematic viscosity. So here we are defining dynamic viscosity. Dynamic means what? The viscosity is in motion. Okay, and when we are considering forces, when external force is required for the motion, so that there we are considering as a dynamic viscosity. And when we are not applying any kind of external force, there we are considering as a kinematic viscosity. So dynamic viscosity or simple viscosity, simply it is also called as viscosity. There is here if viscosity is mentioned, we have to consider it as a dynamic viscosity and notation for it as a mu. So viscosity mu is a measure of resistance to fluid flow as a result of intermolecular cohesion. In other words, viscosity can be seen as a internal friction to the fluid motion, which can lead to energy loss. Different fluids deform at different rates under the same shear stress, and the same with which the fluid pours in an indication of property to viscosity. So that time on that day we have taken one example of syrup and water. If we pour the drop of syrup on a floor, and at the same time if we pour the drop of water on a floor, then which will move faster? Definitely water, because water is having less viscosity, we can say, as it is having molecular molecules is having very less distance among themselves as compared to the molecules of the syrup, and therefore syrup will have more viscosity. So it depends on the distance, molecular distance, internal structure of the fluid, and it is that is called as internal resistance. And why the water is flowing little faster than the molecules of syrup, it depends on one unknown property, and that we call it as a viscosity. And the unit of viscosity is equal to Newton second per meter square. And so typical values of water is 1.14 into 10 raised to minus 3 kg per meter per second, or Newton we can write as a kg meter per second square. I have explained on that day. F is equal to ma. Therefore, viscosity were defined. It is defined by the Newton's law of viscosity. Here actually tau is directly proportional to, proportionality constant is dynamic or absolute viscosity. So tau is directly proportional. Shear stress is, this is called as Newton's law of viscosity. Okay. So shear stress tau is equal to mu into dv by dy. And therefore viscosity mu is coming as tau shear stress divided by shear strain. Or there is a by observing this formula, we can define the dynamic viscosity as a mu is equal to shear stress divided by shear strain, and where shear strain is dv by dy or du by dy. V or u can be used for the velocity nomenclatures. The units is coming as Newton second per meter square. So Newton per meter square and dv by ds we can use as a meter per second meter. So it is coming as Newton second per meter square. So another viscosity is kinematic viscosity, and it is defined as here absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity to the density of the fluid. So another viscosity is kinematic viscosity. It is denoted by letter nu. It is called as nu. Okay, nu is equal to mu divided by rho, and it is also called, because force is not involved, the only dimensions being length and time. So remember that kinematic viscosity can be used when a fluid is not forced, but it is moving with acceleration, with gravity force only, and natural force only. So that type of viscosity is called as, there we have to consider kinematic viscosity. For example, water is flowing in the river. Water is flowing in the river. Then in that case, we have to consider the kinematic viscosity, because we are not applying any kind of external force for that flow. Resistance is there, but we are applying only force here, gravity force or natural force. Then that type of viscosity is called as kinematic viscosity. And another viscosity is dynamic viscosity, where the fluid is forced to have the motion. That there we have to consider the dynamic viscosity. This we have to remember always. Okay. So here, fluid which are forced, for example, pumped. If any fluid is pumped, then in that when and fluid is going for any kind of motion, then we have to consider dynamic viscosity. When fluid is not forced, it is moving, okay, flowing with natural gravity force, it, then we have to consider kinematic viscosity. Okay, is called, so force is not involved, the only dimensions being length and time as kinematic in the kinematics. Okay, so in metric system it had unit centimeter square per second, also known as, and so the CGS unit of this kinematic viscosity is coming as centimeter square per second, or SI unit is equal to meter square per second. So on that day we have covered how the unit is coming as meter square per second. So that viscosity, that unit, CGS unit is centimeter square per second, and it is called as Stoke. ST, it is called what? Stoke. Name given after Sir George Stoke, an English physicist and pioneer investigator. So this concept of viscosity, kinematic viscosity, is developed by the scientist Sir George Stokes, and therefore the name after him here, the name is given as Stokes. So CJ's unit of kinematic viscosity is called as what? Stokes. So kinematic viscosity V is equal to mu upon rho. Unit is meter square per second. Typical values now, because the mu we are knowing and density we are knowing. So from that, water is having 1.14 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square per second is going to be the kinematic viscosity of a water. Okay, air it will become 1.46 into 10 raised to minus 5. In general, okay. So distinction mu of the most fluid is virtually independent of pressures encountered ordinarily in engineering work. So nu of gases varies strongly with pressure because of change in density. So this you remember, but remember that main difference between them is that when a fluid is forced, then we have to consider dynamic viscosity, and when fluid is not forced for its motion, it is only flowing, then it is called as their kinematic viscosity. Now example is there. Reservoir oil has a mass of 1825 kg. The reservoir has a volume of 0.917 meter cube. Compute density, specific weight, and specific gravity of the oil. Reservoir of oil has a mass of 825 kg. Reservoir has a volume. Compute density, specific weight, and specific gravity. So very simple numerical. Rho, reservoir of oil has a mass. So m is given. Volume of reservoir also given, 0.917 meter cube. Mass is equal, rho is equal to, rho of oil is equal to mass upon volume. So mass upon volume, 825 is a SI unit of mass, volume 0.917 meter cube, and it is become 900 kg per meter cube. Then here specific weight of oil is equal to rho into g. Directly we can use the formula, rho of oil into g. So 900 into 9.81, it is becomes 8829 newton per meter cube. And specific gravity will be rho of oil divided by rho of water. So 900 divided by 998 or 1000, 0.9. So this way we can calculate the numerical. Okay. One numerical for practice I want to give you. So write down here. Calculate. Everybody writing? Calculate. Specific weight, density, and specific gravity. Calculate specific weight, comma density, and specific gravity of 1 liter of petrol weighs 9.6 newton. Can you able to calculate it? Anybody of you? Everybody got this numerical on screen? Everybody getting? Can you able to solve? Chat box. Give message in chat box first. Anybody of you? काय कोण कोण सोडू शकते? फक्त एनीबडी ऑफ यू और वेदर माय हेल्प इज रिक्वायर्ड. Whether my help is required? Somebody can?
Yes, sir.
My help is required. Okay, so without wasting time, so very simple numerical. Okay, see, we are knowing formula, but still, because you are not knowing how to convert liter into meter cube. Okay, anybody of you, what is given? So we have to calculate specific gravity. So in our notation. Specific gravity, we have to calculate specific gravity W. Okay, then we have to calculate density. Okay, and we have to calculate the specific gravity. So we can call it as S G or S of petrol. Okay, what is given? 1 liter. What is 1 liter? Anybody?
Volume.
Volume. 1 liter is equal to how much meter cube? Anybody? We have in thermodynamics lecture. I have told you what is 1 liter is equal 10, to. 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. Now you can solve. So volume is equal to 1 liter 10 raised to minus 3, and weighs means what is that? Weight, capital W, weight is equal to 9.6 newton. Okay, so weight divided by volume, so directly what will get? Anybody of you, what is specific weight? Correct. The small W is equal to here, specific weight is equal to here weight divided by volume. Weight divided by volume. So how much weight is there? 9.6 divided by volume is 10 raised to minus 3 is coming as how much? Anybody of you? 9600 newton per newton per meter cube. Getting? Now we know the small W. Shall we calculate density now? Anybody of you? Small W is equal to rho into g. Okay, therefore small W is equal to rho into g, and therefore here what we can call rho is equal to small W divided by g. Okay, and is equal to how? Is equal to 9600 divided by 9.81. We'll do this calculation. It is equal to, anybody of you who is having calculator, 9600 divided by 9.81. What is the answer?
9.59.
What is the unit? Kg per meter cube. Okay. And what is then specific gravity? Specific gravity will be Sg or S is equal to rho of petrol divided by rho of water. So it is equal to 9.78 divided by you will take roughly you take 1000. That is not the big issue. 1000. It is coming as anybody of you. Point. Near about, huh? Anybody of everybody got this? Everybody got this? Now, can you able to solve this?
Sir.
Ha.
Sir, rho is equal to mass upon volume.
Ha. Yeah, ha. So
then W by G.
Ha? No, it is what they asked for density. So density and specific weight. The specific weight we can calculate. W is equal to weight upon volume. So we have calculated specific weight, not weight. Weight is 9.6 Newton, but we have calculated specific weight. And relation is there in between specific weight and density. What is that relation? Density, specific weight is equal to density into acceleration due to gravity. And therefore, rho is equal to W upon G. Or if you want to calculate simply weight, so from that weight is equal to, if you want to calculate first density, then weight is equal to what? Mass into
mg.
Mg.
Okay, sir.
Or the right, you can calculate mass per divided by g, and then you can calculate density. But here we are calculating directly specific weight or weight density, and from that, well, there is one relationship between weight density and density, and that we are calculating. Now, everybody got this?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now, same numerical I want to call for you, okay? So only change is calculate, or okay, I'll write, calculate density comma weight density of 1 liter of petrol having specific gravity calculate the specific gravity 0.9. Also calculate its weight. Okay. So calculate weight. Anybody, all of you can do it? All of you can calculate? Can you calculate? Written message, can you able to calculate? Calculate and write the answers in message box, chat box. Can you able to calculate? Nobody is responding. सर लेक्चर तो ले हेलो 15 मिनट का हो सर हाँ आदल are you able to calculate? Are you able to calculate? Yes, yes, okay. Okay, do it. Okay, so calculate weight density. So I will start. So specific gravity is given. So now S of oil is given here. Okay, S of 9 is given. S of oil is given as 0.9. Okay. So volume is also given as what? 1 liter. So I will write volume is equal to 10^-3. 10^-3 meter cube. Okay. If you are getting answer, you can write in message box. No problem. I will. Those are not solving or not. Okay. Very good. So I will check answer. Very good. Density 900. So correct. Correct. I have deleted. Density 900, weight 8.89. You give unit for weight and specific weight. Okay, very good. Then S of oil. So here in that case, your specific gravity is equal to rho of oil. Divided by rho of water. Okay. And this implies that here rho of water, sorry, rho of oil is equal to specific weight of oil into rho of water. So 0.9 into 1000. Roughly, you take 1000 as density of water, and is coming as 900 kg per meter cube. Okay. Now, if you get rho density, specific weight is equal to rho into g, and is coming as here 1000 sorry, not 1000. It's coming as 900. Into 81, and this is coming as 881. Who would tell? Who is the answer? Eight eight one. Somebody can.
8829.
8829. Newton. Point six that afterwards. 8829 Newton per meter cube. And weight will be here in that case. It will weight will be 98. We'll calculate weight will specific weight is equal to weight upon volume. Therefore, weight is equal to 8.829 Newton. Specific weight is equal to weight upon volume. Therefore, weight is equal to specific weight into volume. And volume is equal to 10 raised to minus 3. So, minus 3 means 8.829. You would understand this? Such kind of numericals we are asking in previously. But now I think you are having. Okay. So, this kind of numericals we have taken now only. Then, surface tension. Anybody of you surface tension, how we define surface tension? The surface tension is caused due to cohesion force of attraction only. Surface tension is caused due to cohesion force of attraction. And how it is defined as? Here, surface tension coefficient can be defined as the intensity of Vankaran Borel Argent. Meeting the Argent Borel Vankaran. Office together earlier. Surface tension coefficient can be defined as the intensity of intermolecular traction or cohesion per unit length along the free surface of a liquid. So what happens when here when let us consider this as a one container, and this is considered as, let us consider this is filled with water. So this vessel is filled with water. So all these molecules are there. It is having cohesive force of attraction between each other. What is meant by cohesive force of attraction? Anybody of you? Cohesive force of attraction. Anybody of you?
Attraction between same medium.
Okay, same molecule. Okay, so this molecule and this molecule is having cohesive force of attraction. So due to that, what will happen? The molecules which are completely submerged in liquid. Let us consider this molecule A. It is complete, and it will here. Attracted by all similar molecules surrounded to it. Now it will understand my diagram. I'm facing some problem. Okay, with this mouse and okay, I am drawing with mouse. Okay, so all the molecules, those are completely submerged in the liquid, they will possess resultant force of attraction will be how much? Anybody of you? Same force, but other directions also it is applicable.
Zero.
So resultant force, okay, zero. Okay, so those molecules are there which are completely submerged in this particular liquid, possess zero force of cohesive attraction. So therefore, it will become in equilibrium condition. But those molecules will be at the free surface. So this is called what? Free surface. Okay. where free surface means what? It distinguishes between the liquid and other medium, that is air. Okay, so those molecules are there. Let us consider these are at the surface, so only they will possess downward force of attraction, and therefore resultant force will be in which direction? Anybody of you? Downward. Maybe half molecule will be there. Over there. Okay. So in that case, resultant force will be in the which direction?
Downward.
Downward direction. So the molecules which are at the free surface, they will possess a downward direction force because of what? Cohesive force of attraction of its of surrounding its own molecules. Okay, and therefore this free surface is acts like a stretched membrane under tension, and this is this tensile force. Diha tensile force jo act hoto, this tensile force is called as surface tension force and denoted by letter sigma. Everybody got it? What is that? The surface, the molecules which are at the free surface of the liquid possess a downward force, and due to that downward force, tensile force, the membrane, the free surface acts like a stretched membrane. म्हणजे अशी एक प्रकारचा अशी दोरीला आपण कसं एखाद्या धुण्या जर वाळत गेलं कपडे क्लॉथ आपण जर त्यामध्ये हे केले पुटअप केले तर कशी दोरी टेन्शन न खाली येते. लाईक दॅट हिअर द फ्री सर्फेस ऍक्ट लाईक ए स्ट्रेच्ड मेम्ब्रेन अंडर टेन्शन अँड दॅट फोर्स टेन्साईल फोर्स इज कॉल्ड ऍज सर्फेस टेन्शन फोर्स अँड इट इज हॅव्हिंग युनिट न्यूटन पर मीटर. पर मीटर लेंथ ऑफ दॅट सर्फेस हाउ मच फोर्स इज ऍक्टिंग. इट इज टेन्साईल फोर्स. सो टेन्साईल फोर्स ऍक्टिंग ऑन द free surface of a liquid, any liquid, due to which the free surface looks like a stretched membrane under tension, and that is called as here surface tension force denoted by sigma newton per meter. Okay, now this surface tension force is caused due to only cohesive force of attraction. No other force is responsible for it, only cohesive force of attraction, and that is called as here surface tension force. Now this surface tension force, whether it is desirable or undesirable, anybody of you? Surface tension force, whether it is desirable or undesirable, anybody of you? Whether it is desirable or undesirable, काय शकतो? In some application it is desirable. In some application it is undesirable. Some application it is desirable, some applications it is undesirable. Now where it is desirable? Now when we want that liquid should not be evaporated, for example petrol tank. So this is one tank, petrol is there in this tank and petrol is there, we want that it should not be evaporated. So at that time this free surface tension force should be much more, so that easily the fluid, more molecules should not escape from to the air. Okay, and in case of boiling of milk or water, we want that here boiling or conversion of water into vapor. So in that case this surface tension force is undesirable, because if surface tension force is more, then more heat we have to produce. So in depending on the application, the surface tension force is somewhat desirable, some application it is undesirable. And we can add some chemical solutions to increase or decrease this particular surface tension force. So we can additives in petrol, some additives we are adding so that it will decrease or increase the surface tension force. Okay, so this is about the surface tension force. So this is surface tension magnitudes, you know that. Now this is not, you have learned in this 12 standards, so will not that much formulas. So properties again, cohesion, it is a property of the fluid by which particles of the same fluid are attracted. Surface tension is mainly due to cohesion force of attraction. Adhesion, it is a property of the fluid by which particles of the different fluids or solid and fluid are attracted. Capillary is mainly due to cohesion. Okay, difference between adhesion and cohesive forces. Distinction is usually made between adhesive force, which acts to hold two separate bodies another, or to stick one body to another. Cohesive force, which acts as a hold together like or unlike atoms, ions or molecules of a single body. The cohesive, when sticking, we adhesion either to stick something. So Fevikic or Fevicol is having more adhesive force of attraction. Now capillarity. What is meant by capillary? Anybody of you? Capillary, okay. Rise or fall of liquid in capillary tube caused by surpetension. Capillary depends on a relative magnitudes of the cohesion of the liquid. So when a capillary tube is immersed in some liquids, okay, liquids, then the liquid is having tendency to rise or decrease the level in capillary tube with respect to adjacent level. That is called as capillarity rise or fall. Now, if the capillary tube is immersed in liquid like water, okay, whose cohesive force of attraction is less, then in that case capillarity rise will take place. And when the fluids which are having cohesive force of attraction more, for example mercury is a solid, as its molecules are very much closer to each other, so in that case here cohesive force of attraction is too much and it is a dominating adhesive force. Means in that case glass surface and mercury, so mercury doesn't stick with glass and therefore it is having zero adhesive force with glass and it is having more cohesive force. So in that case, when capillary tube is immersed in a liquids fluids like mercury, where cohesive force of attraction is too much than the adhesive force, then capillary fall will take place like this. And when the capillary tube is immersed in liquids whose cohesive force of attraction is less as compared to adhesion, so we know that glass, water weighs glass. जर आपण ग्लास मध्ये जर पाणी ठेवलं तर ग्लासचा सरफेस काय होतो, वेट म्हणजे ओला होतो. म्हणजे वॉटर इज हॅव्हिंग मोर अडेसिव्ह फोर्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्लास ऍज कम्पेअर टू इट्स ओन कोहेसिव्ह फोर्स. इन दॅट केस म्हटलं आपण कॅपिलिटी फॉल विल टेक प्लेस. सो वेन कॅपिलरी ट्यूब इज इमर्स्ड इन अ लिक्विड, इट्स लेवल ऑफ लिक्विड इन द कॅपिलरी ट्यूब मे राईज ऑर फॉल. दॅट टेंडन्सी ऑफ लिक्विड टू राईज ऑर फॉल इन कॅपिलरी ट्यूब इज कॉल्ड ऍज कॅपिलरिटी. And capillarity rise where it will take place? When cohesive force of attraction is what? Less as compared to adhesion, or adhesion dominates cohesive, so capillarity rise will take place. And when cohesion dominates adhesion in like mercury, here capillarity fall will take place. Okay, now we'll stop here. Everybody understood up to this? Then we'll stop. Everybody understood up to this? Yes, Kunal is saying yes. Kunal replying after so much time. Diksha, yes, okay. So put your attendance in message box. Put your attendance in message box and then we'll leave the class. Put your roll numbers. After putting your roll numbers only, you have to, if you are allowed to, leave the class.